is against a database. It is possible to run a SQL statement directly against a database while using entity framework. This means you can run statements like this, select star from, in your own SQL language directly from the entity framework. Firstly, why would this be required? One reason that this would be required is that your select query is too long, too complicated, consisting of multiple joins, that writing an expression tree will itself be a time consuming task. Time consuming expression trees. This is one reason. Second would be that even if you succeed in writing an expression tree, but that expression tree might not be correctly translated into the desired select query. After all, there is a machine doing that conversion, and that machine might not be able to convert it correctly into the desired endpoint SQL because of the involved complexity. So there are reasons, there will be times when you will actually need to write your own mechanism so that a SQL query can be directly run against a database. Now the question is, what type of queries? Like, okay, the queries are select, you have one types of queries called select, update, delete, insert. Now these three types of queries you will never need to directly run, because update will always take against an object and will always occur against a database table, which is always, almost always correctly mapped by the designer. Updating will never be an issue because update will always take place against a single table. And that table is always mapped to your entity classes. I am not talking about sequential updates or transactions. I am talking about one update running against one table. Sequential updates can always be taken care of by stored procedures, or can always be taken care by running the queries in a sequence. So update is never an issue, delete will also not be an issue. You will always have a primary key and you can always issue a delete command against that. And for the same reason, insert. This means these three types of queries will always be 100% handled by the link, by the entity system that we have studied so far. The only issue will be when you are issuing a select statement, which is too long, too complex. So we shall learn how to issue select statements directly to a database from entity classes. This is the way we do. We use the data context obtain CTX is equal to new data context and pass the connection string. So once you have the context, then you can write CTX dot execute query and you can pass the string select star from whatever. So this is the main scheme that works around for us. Get hold of the data context and call execute query. Now how will the end results coming from the select query map to your collection classes or map to your list consisting of objects? Suppose you have a database table called T, TBLX let me call. It has a column called call 1, call 2, call 3. And in my code I have a corresponding C# class called class TBLX having properties call 1, call 2, call 3. That is I have a C# class that is mapped automatically through say keeping the names same or by applying mappings. This class is mapped to a database table called TBLX. So I need a mapping that should exist, or it should be an automatic mapping. If you have a class with the same name as the table and properties having same name as the columns, such a thing is already done by your designer. The link designer does the same thing. It actually maintains the names and column names, so it is automatically mapped. Now all I have to do is, suppose I want to do a selection of call 1, call 2, call 3 from this TBLX. Then I have to write ctx.executeQuery, and here I should write the class, the properties of which will map to the respective, look here, I'll write TBLX, this is my C# class, and here I write the statement select call 1, call 2, call 3 from whatever. Now this C# class called TBLX has to have properties by the name call 1, call 2 and call 3. Although the sequence in which you write them inside the C# class is not of importance, but there should be one property having name call 1 that maps with data type to this one. Similarly call 2, similarly call 3. All I have to do is put the correct class in this generic and ensure that the select statement returns all the columns that can be mapped to properties on TBLX. You can also write select star in case it has only three columns, call 1, call 2 and call 3. So the results of this where query is equal to ctx.executeQueryTBLX whatever. These results will contain a collection of TBLX objects as obtained from the database. Consider another example. Now suppose I have to run a select statement by giving aliases. I write select call 1 as blog, comma call 2 as blog ID. Maybe these are coming out of a complex join also, and I can always give aliases. I can always give aliases to the columns that are coming as a result of a complex join. Supposing I give aliases as blog and blog ID. Then I should have a class, C# class. Let me call that class as X. It must have properties same as blog and blog ID. Blog ID. The data type of blog should map to the data type of this, and data type of this should map to the data type on this. Because I know that I'm writing the select query. When I'm writing the select query, I should give aliases and simultaneously create a class for C# that consists of these properties matched. I must have a C# class, the properties of which will map the aliases I give in the select statement. So since I am writing the select statement myself, I know these aliases, I'll have to also simultaneously create a class X or whatever name I want to give to it with the corresponding properties. Now how can I do it is, I can simply write where query is equal to ctx dot execute query, the name of the table, the name of the C# class, C# model class. This class I have already written because I knew what query I am going to write. And then in the arguments you can write double quote select call one as blog, comma call two as blog ID, and complete the query in whatever form I want. So when this query is executed against the database, this object will contain a collection of X C# objects. Now let us run it and see how to do it correctly. Create a basic C# application, MVC, and our database in this case has already been added, and this is TBL blog consisting of blog heading, blog date and ID. And it has been also automatically mapped by the entity designer. And let me have a look at it. It consists of a C# class called TBL blog ID, the same names. So before I can proceed, I'll need my connection string. Right click, properties, and let me see whether I can get the connection string. I'll have to right click, properties, and double click it, copy, and here I can write string con, string is equal to at the rate. So I'll have to make some replacement single quote. So this is my connection string. And now what I can do is, I'll use the index method here, return get data and add public string get data. Here I can write where using, I'll obtain that context using data context ctxt is equal to new data context, pass the connection string. I'll have to resolve this data context. Resolve, something is wrong here. So I'll have to add reference. It should be system.data.link and click OK. And now I can right click and find the resolve here using system.data.link. Okay. Now I can write where query is equal to ctxt dot execute query, and I'll bring tbl blog. I'll have to resolve tbl blog also. Resolve entity models, because I have entered them into entity models folder, so I have to resolve it. And here I'll write in double quotes the query that I'm trying to write. Select star from tbl blog. Let me check out whether it is tbl blog or blogs. Tbl blog. And string builder sb is equal to new string builder for each string, for each where v in query. I can write sb dot append format. Id is equal to 0. Just writing anything, so I'll not worry about whether I'm giving the correct. Comma v dot id comma v dot blog heading. And then I can return sb dot toString.